ॐ गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान् शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात्परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, वी आर् इन् दिस् म वी हेव् टु स्टार्ट् दिस् मन्त्र, एय्त् मन्त्र, दट् ईस् आशा प्रतीक्षे सङ्गतं सूनृतां च। So we have seen how one gentleman named Vajasravasa, he was performing a yajna, and then his son, he watched his father giving all this, say, danam, dakshina and all that, and then he felt bad that he was giving away all these old decrepit cows. So he felt that his father was not going to get going to good lokas, and then he intervened, and then he asked, "Oh father, to whom are you giving me so that I can be of some service to that gentleman?" So when he insisted on that, then the father got angry, and then in a whiff of in a fit of anger, he said, "Okay, I am giving you to Lord Yama." So accordingly, then he convinced his father, "Okay, let your word be true, because in all our family, if you see, all our forefathers, they have kept up their words, so you have to keep up your word. I will go to Lord Yama." So he went, and then he stayed there for about three nights, and then Lord Yama was not there, so he waited for him. So when Lord Yama returned, then his servants or ministers or some people, they told him, "Yeah, this gentleman, who is a very well read Brahmin, he has come, and then he is waiting at your gate, and then for three days and nights he did not have any food, he was not attended upon." So then Yama feels bad that an atithi, a person who comes as a guest, he comes like a fire, and then that gentle, if that fire is not properly quenched, that means if atithi is not properly taken care of, the basic concept is atithi yajna. Atithi yajna is, that is one type of sacrifice. In fact, that is one of the compulsory sacrifices for, or nitya karma rather, it is one of the compulsory karmas, compulsory activities for a grihastha, for a householder, atithi yajna, that is giving food to anybody, a guest who comes home. So this I have not done, so okay, let not any bad thing befall me, let me propitiate this boy, let me say please this boy. So Yama is in that mood. So Yama is just this Vaishwanara Pravishati Atithir Brahmano Gruhan. So that is what Yama's assistants, they told him. He is coming, an Atithi comes like a Vaishwanara. So you please him. Then something more they are saying. Asha, let us read this mantra. Asha Pratikshe,
Asha Pratikshe,
Sangatam Sunrutam Cha,
Sangatam Sunrutam Cha,
Ishtapurte,
Ishtapurte,
Putra Pashukumscha Sarvan,
Putra Pashukumscha
एतद्वृङ्क्ते पुरुषस्याल्पमेधसो यस्यानश्नन् वसति ब्राह्मणो गृहे। सो दिस् मन्त्र सेस् दट् इफ् ए गेस्ट् कम्स् अण्ड् देन् इफ् ही स्टेस् विदौट् फुड् इन् एनी अन्फार्चुनेट् पर्सन्स् हौस्, देन् दट् ईस् गोयिङ्ग् टु टेक् अवे वाट्? Asha Pratikshe. Asha, suppose you are hoping for something, you are hoping to say achieve something, you are hoping to achieve some result, you are hoping to say maybe your son is getting into IIT, or your son is getting into some other thing, or you are yourself getting some huge benefits from somewhere. So that is hope of something which is possible to achieve, but it is not very very clear, not exactly clear. So that is hope. Then pratiksha is waiting, something is in the pipeline, your promotion papers are about to be signed. So that is pratiksha. Iksha means seeing, pratiksha means prati plus iksha, pratiksha, that is just waiting. So asha is hope, then pratiksha is expectation. So a guest who stays in somebody's house, some unfortunate person's house without food, etc. So that sin is going to take away all these things. What are all these things? Asha, pratiksha, your hope and expectation, they are gone. So whatever who you are hoping, that will be wrecked. Whatever expectation you are having, that will be wrecked. So that wreck, that root wreck also is going to be used in this mantra. Yetad vrunkte, vrunkte, it wrecks, it destroys. Then asha pratikshe, sangatam. Sangatam is by having this satsangatyam. Satsangatyam is what is it satsangatyam? Say company of good people. Good people means learned people. Say people who are really educated in Brahma Vidya, who are in the right path. Satsangatyam. Satsangatyam does not mean normally good people, ordinarily good for nothing people, but really educated people. Good here means not good for nothing, but good means educated. Educated and useful people. And we know that famous thing, satsangatve nissangatvam. Nissangatve nirmohatvam. That line is there, that Jivan Mukti, that line of Shankaracharya is there. So, satsangatve nissangatvam. So, this satsangatyam is going to lead you to nissangatva. So, this satsangatyam, that company can be called satsangatyam if it is going to give you some knowledge, if it is going to make you aware of some rudiments of Brahmajnana. So some such benefit should be there. So that is satsangatyam. So the benefits of satsangatyam also will be taken away. Then sangatam sunrutam cha. Sunrutam, sunruta vani means pleasant, all good talk, all pleasant talk. You have been using very good words to everybody. And then all the effect, good effect of that, all the good words, that will also be taken away. Sunrutam, ishta purte, ishta and purtam. Ishtam and purtam are two technical words. Ishta purtam it is called. Ishtam is yagam. Ishti is actually yagam. That is any type of yaga. Purta is any socially beneficial activity, like you are suppose there is no well in a particular locality. You are digging a well and providing some water to them. Suppose you are constructing some sort of shelter, in olden days, like we have some guest houses now. They used to build shelters. They are called arama. Yeah, some sort of arama. That is some shelters. And then you plant some trees all along the road, and so that they will give some shade to the people. So all the, or you say give some money and get some tanks dug. So all these things which are socially beneficial activities, they are called purtam. Vapi koopa tataka adi, that is what they are going to say. Vapi is well, koopam is a fairly bigger well, tataka is a pond, then arama is a shelter. So all these things, these are all useful for the people. So this is denoted by the word purtam. So ishta purte is in dvivachana. Ishtam and purtam, when you combine it, ishta purte, it becomes ishta purte. Putra pasugunscha sarvan. Putra and pashu. Putra, putra means children, not only son but children. Pashu was the wealth in olden days. So this pashu wealth, cattle wealth, was the main wealth in olden days. So this wealth, so all these things, they will be wrecked, they will be taken away, they will be destroyed, or they will be some negative impact will be there on all these things. If a guest is not properly taken care of, so this is some sort of dharma sutra. So some dharma sutra is some norm in olden days. This is a norm which was supposed to be followed by every householder. So that is the thing here. So let us read this mantra. We have read this mantra. Asha pratikshe, I explained. Sangatam is company, good company. Sunrutam, that good, all these pleasant, all these good words. Ishta purte, I explained. Putra pasugunscha sarvan. Yetad vrunkte. Vrunkte means wrecks. It wrecks, it destroys, it takes away. Purushasya alpamedhasaha. Alpamedhaha. Alpamedhaha means a person who is having a dull wit. A dull-witted person. अल्पमेधसः इज षष्टि एकवचनम पुरुषस्य अल्पमेधसः पुरुषः अल्पमेधाः इज प्रथम एकवचनम अल्पमेधसः इज षष्टि एकवचनम पुरुषस्य अल्पमेधसः दैट इज ऑफ ए पर्सन हु इज अ डलविटेड पर्सन आर हियर लेट अस से एन अनफॉर्चुनेट पर्सन देन यस्य अनश्नन अनश्नन मीन्स नॉट हैविंग फूड यस्य गृहे अनश्नन ब्राह्मण वसति दट इज इन हूज हाउस ए ब्राह्मण मीन्स ए लर्नेड ब्राह्मण ब्राह्मण डज नॉट मीन बै कैस्ट ब्राह्मण मीन्स ए लर्नेड मैन ए पर्सन हू इज ज्ञानी ए पर्सन ऑफ कोर्स हियर दिस नचिकेता इज स्टिल नॉट एट ए ज्ञानी बट ही इज ए पर्सन हू इज वेल रेड इन द वेदास He is having some superficial knowledge, theoretical knowledge of all these things. He has undergone this Shravanam and Mananam. So he is at that level. So only thing is, he has to receive the final nod. He has to receive the final nod or from final, say, last, say, what you call, the last few bits from Lord Yama. So he has theoretically acquired all the knowledge of the Vedas. But then it has to be sanctified by Lord Yama. Lord Yama has to give some final tips to this gentleman. So he is at that stage. So let us read the Bhashyam. Sir, where is this? Yatascha. Akarane Pratyavaya Shruyate.
Akarane Pratyavaya Shruyate.
Pratyavaya is one word which we are also familiar in Gita Bhashyam. Pratyavaya. Nityanam Akarane Pratyavaya. If you do not do Nityakarma, there is a Pratyavaya. Pratyavaya is a negative fallout. Prati plus ava plus aya. Prati means against. Ava means down. Aya means gati. That is movement. So an opposite downward movement. So that is it. So upward movement is abhyudaya. Downward movement is pratyavaya. So this pratyavaya. Yascha akarane pratyavaya shruyate. Pratyavaya is heard. If you do not take care of a guest, there is it is going to give a negative fallout, negative result. Asha pratikshe.
Asha pratikshe.
Anirgnyata. Prapya.
Prapya.
Ishtartha prarthana asha.
Ishtartha prarthana asha.
So for asha, for the word asha, Shankaracharya is giving a very long explanation. Anirgnyata. Prapya ishta artha prarthana asha. Anirgnata, something which is unknown. Anirgnata, gnata is known. Anirgnata is unknown. Not very clearly known, let us say. Then prapya. Prapya means something which is attainable. Something which is attainable, that is a hope. You have got a hope that your son is making to say some good university somewhere or something like that. So that is a hope. Anirgnyata, that is attainable, but it is attainable. Prapya, ishtartha prarthana. Ishtartha, something which is desired. Ishta is something which is desired. Artha prarthana, so that is asha. You follow this?
Yes.
Asha is very clear. He has used three words. That is, one thing is unknown. Then number two, prapya means attainable. Then ishtartha, something which is desired. So all these combined, it makes asha. Then what is pratiksha? Nirgnyata. प्राप्यार्थ प्रतीक्षणं प्रतीक्षा सो ओके निर्ज्ञात मीन्स समथिंग विच इज नोन प्रॉपरली नोन देन दट इज एक्सपेक्टेड आल्सो निर्ज्ञात प्राप्य दट इज अटेनबल युअर सन हैज रिटन एन एग्जामिनेशन एंड देन यू आर वेटिंग फॉर द रिजल्ट आर युअर बॉस इज अबाउट टू साइन युअर से प्रमोशन पेपर्स सो दट इज समथिंग विच इज नोन एंड इट इज एक्सपेक्टेड प्राप्य अर्थ प्रतीक्षण अर्थ मीन्स दट इज दट विच इज डिजायर्ड इज अर्थ प्राप्यार्थ प्रतीक्षण प्रतीक्षण मीन्स वेटिंग प्रतीक्षण ईज कॉल्ड प्रतीक्षा एक्सपेक्टेशन ते आशा प्रतीक्षे आशा प्रतीक्षे इज ड्यूअल नंबर आशा एंड प्रतीक्षा वेन यू कंबाइन दे बिकम आशा प्रतीक्षे Then, sangatam, sat-sanyogajam phalam, sunrutamcha, sunrutahi, priyavak, tannimittamcha. So, this sangatam and sunrutam he is explaining. Sangatam is sat-sanyogajam phalam. So, the benefit which you derive by being in a satsanga, satsanga means learned people, learned in scriptures, those who are useful for your elevation, those who are elevation in the sense, those who are useful for self-realization, they will give you some inputs relating to Brahma Jnanam. So that is the company which can be called Satsangatya. Then Sunruta, Sunruta is what? Sunruta hi Priya Vak. Priya Vak. Vak is feminine, so that is why it is said Priya Vak. That is good words about everybody. Say not only good words, this Priyam is something which is again there is a technical definition for that. When you are not supposed to flatter people. If you are flattering people, that is unfair, that is not correct. But you are supposed to tell about the good qualities of the people. You are supposed to identify the good qualities of the people and then tell them. That is what is Priya Vak. Satyam Bruyat, Priyam Bruyat. Na Bruyat, Satyam Apriyam. Priyam cha na anrutam bruyat. So that there is one line from Ramayana. That is Satyam Bruyat, Priyam Bruyat. Always you have to speak truth. But at the same time, you should also tell what is priyam, what is liked by the people, what is useful, what is liked by the people. So, and priyam cha na anrutam bruyat. Then, suppose anrutam means falsehood. This falsehood should not be spoken even if it is pleasing. So, that means you are not supposed to praise a person unfairly. Only when there is a merit you praise, when there is no merit you are not supposed to praise. Priyam cha na anrutam bruyat esha dharmas sanatana. This is a general say subhashita. So like that, this priya vak does not mean flattering. Priya vak is not flattering, that is recognizing the good in others and expressing to them. So that is priya vak. So that again is going to give you some punyam. That again is going to, it is generally good manners, apart from being good manners, it is also giving all people some happiness. Then all these things, priya vak, tan nimittam cha, that is the benefit which is accruing out of that. Ishta purte
istam yagajam purtam
aramadi kriyajam phalam. Ishta purte, istam and purtam, they are combinedly called Ishtapurte. Ishtam is what? Yagajam. That is that which is coming out of a yaga. Yagam is yajna. Yajna, yagam and yajnam are one and the same. Slight difference people say. Devatodeshena dravyatyagaha yagaha. That is how it is said. Devatodeshena dravyatyagaha yagaha. So all these yagas technically which are mentioned in the Shrutis, they are yagas. There can be some yajnas. Like we saw in Gita, where there is no real dravyatyaga, where there may not be dravyatyaga. Somebody is doing pranayama, somebody is doing self-restraint, somebody is doing something else. So all these things, they are also called yajna. Somebody is doing jnana yajna. So that jnana yajna cannot be called yaga. So that is the slight difference between yaga and yajna. Anyway, yagajam phalam. Yaga is here, of course, devatodeshena dravyatyaga. So by keeping a deity in view, keeping a god or some god form in view, you are giving dravyatyaga. You are giving all types of donations, giving all types of dhanams. So that is it. That is yagajam phalam. Purtam means aramadi kriyajam phalam. Arama, I was explaining. Arama means a shelter, a place of shelter. Like chowdhury. In olden days, they used to build some chowdhuries all along the roads. So now, of course, you have got some guest houses. So like that. Aramadi kriyajam phalam. Then, putra pashunscha.
Putranscha pashunscha.
Sarvan etat sarvam.
Yathoktam.
Urumkte avarjayati. Vinashayati ityetat. So all these things are, they are wrecked, they are destroyed, they are harmed by not attending on an atithi. Then purushasya alpa prajnya is a fellow who is a dull-witted fellow. Or a very, very unfortunate fellow who is not taking care of his guest. Then, yasya anashnan abhunjanaha brahmano gruhe vasati. That is, in whose house a brahmin stays without having food. यस्य अनश्नन् अनश्नन् मीन्स् अभुञ्जानः विदौट् ईटिङ्ग् अभुञ्जानः ब्राह्मणः गृहे वसति ब्राह्मण अगेन् इस् ए लर्नेड् मेन् ए ज्ञानी देन् तस्मात् अनुपेक्षणीयः सर्वावस्थास्वपि अतिथिः इत्यर्थः सो दिस् इस् ए जनरल् स्टेट्मेण्ट् अबौट् दि अतिथि यज्ञ सर्वास्वस्थासु अण्डर् आल् सर्कम्स्टान्सस् सर्वासु अवस्थासु अण्डर् आल् सर्कम्स्टान्सस् इन् आल् सिचुवेशन्स् ए गेस्ट् शुड् नाट् बि इग्नोर्ड् वट् एवर् बि युवर् सिचुवेशन् वट् एवर् बि युवर् पोजिशन् ए गेस्ट् शुड् नाट् बि इग्नोर्ड् सो दट् इस् इट् देन् नेक्स्ट् मन्त्र तिस्रो रात्रीः तिस्रो यदवात्सीर्गृहे मे यु गाट् द मन्त्र आर् नाट् नो नो भाष्यम् इस् नाट् देर् भाष्यम् इस् ओवर् लेट् अस् रीड् द मन्त्र
तिस्रो रात्रीः
यदवात्सीर्गृहे मे अनश्नन् ब्रह्मन् अतिथिर्नमस्यः नमस्तेऽस्तु ब्रह्मन् स्वस्ति मेऽस्तु तस्मात् प्रति त्रीन् वरान् वृणीष्व सो यम दिस् ईस् द डयलाग् आफ् लार्ड् यम यम इस् सेयिङ्ग् तिस्रो रात्रिर् यदवात्सीर्गृहे मे सो इन् मै हौस् यू हेव् वेटेड् फर् त्री नैट्स् मीन्स् इन्क्लूडिङ्ग् त्री डेस् नार्मली वी डोण्ट् से डेस् त्री डेस् इन् सम्हौ इट् ईस् इन् अवर् से इन् अवर् बुक्स् वी सी नवरात्रि दो इट् ईस् 9 days, we don't refer to it as we say Navaratri. Then, this is something like Pancha Ratram, Pancha 5 nights. So, here, Tisro Ratrihi, 3 nights. Tisro Ratrihi, Yadavatsihi Gruhe Me. You waited in my house, Me Gruhe, Avatsihi. You stayed, you waited. Avatsihi Vasadhatu, Vasadhatu means to stay. Then, Anashnan Brahman Atithir Namasyaha. Hey Brahman, O Brahman. Brahman means O Brahmin. Atithihi, you are an Atithi. Then, Namasyaha. You are a venerable man. You are a respectable man. Namasya. Namaskara, you know. Namaskara is say salutation. Namasya is one who deserves salutation is Namasya. Namaha is Namaskar. Then, Namasya is one who deserves respect, one who is a venerable man. You are a very learned Brahmana. So, you deserve to be respected. So, and such a man, you stayed in my house for 3 nights without having any food. And because of that, Namaste astu Brahman, O Brahman, O Brahmin, Namaste astu, Namaha te astu. Let my salutations to you. Swasti me astu. For me also, let not any evil befall. Su plus asti is swasti. People say swasti, swasti vachakam. What is swasti vachakam? Swasti punyaha vachakam we say. Swasti means let good befall. Swasti mayastu means may good befall me. That means may not any evil befall me. Su plus asti, swasti, may astu. For me, let good befall me. Though I have inadvertently failed in my duty of giving food to you, it is basically an inadvertent act on the part of Yama. So, though inadvertently I have failed in my Atithi Yajna, but still, let not any bad thing befall me, let good befall me. And then, so I am offering my salutation to you, and then, तस्मात् प्रति त्रीन् वरान् वृणीष्व तस्मात् प्रति सो इन् रिटर्न् फ़र् ईच् नैट्स् अनश्नन् उपवास इन् ईच् फ़र् ईच् नैट्स् उपवास त्रीन् वरान् वृणीष्व वृणीष्व मीन्स् यू चूस् वृणीष्व वरणम् इस् चूसिङ्ग् ईवन् इन् मेरेज् यू से वधु अण्ड् वर वर मीन्स् द चोसन् पर्सन् वर is from the same dhatu, I think ruhi or something, I will check out. That dhatu means to choose. Varaha means a person who is chosen. Vrunishva means you choose. So that is it. Treen varan vrunishva. You please choose 3 varas, 3 boons for each night. So that is the meaning here. Let us read the bhashyam. Eva muktaha
mrutyuruvacha
నచికేతసం ఉపగమ్య పూజాపురస్సరం. సో పూజాపురస్సరం నచికేతం నచికేతసం ఉపగమ్య. సో పూజాపురస్సరం మీన్స్ మేబీ విత్ ఫోల్డెడ్ హ్యాండ్స్ పూజాపురస్సరం, ఆర్ మేబీ హీస్ గెటింగ్ సమ్ వాటర్, హీఈస్ గెటింగ్ సమ్ అదర్ ఆఫరింగ్ అండ్ దెన్ పూజాపురస్సరం. పూజాపురస్సరం మీన్స్ విత్ సమ్ డూయింగ్ సమ్ నమస్కారం ఆర్ బ్రింగింగ్ సర్టన్ థింగ్స్. దెన్ నచికేతసం నచికేతసం ఉపగమ్య. సో హీ అప్రోచ్డ్ హ్యావింగ్ అప్రోచ్డ్ నచికేత మృత్యు ఉవాచ. మృత్యు దట్ ఈస్ లార్డ్ యమ టోల్డ్ లైక్ దిస్. సో ఏవ ముక్త మీన్స్ హ్యావింగ్ బీన్ టోల్డ్ బై హీస్ ఫాలోవర్స్ అబౌట్ ద పర్సన్ హూ వాజ్ వెయిటింగ్ ఫర్ ది లాస్ట్ త్రీ నైట్స్, దెన్ ద మృత్యు లార్డ్ యమ కేమ్ విత్ సమ్ సార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆఫరింగ్స్ ఎట్సెట్రా అండ్ దెన్ అప్రోచ్డ్ దిస్ మ్యాన్ దెన్ అండ్ టోల్డ్ లైక్ దిస్. తిస్రో రాత్రి యస్మాత్ అవాత్సీ ఉషితవాన్ అసి గృహే మే మమ అనశ్నన్ హే బ్రహ్మన్ అతిథిస్ సన్ నమస్యః నమస్కారార్హశ్చ తస్మాత్ నమస్తే తుభ్యం అస్తు భవతు. ఓకే, సో దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ సింపుల్ వర్డ్స్ ఓన్లీ. తిస్రో రాత్రి యత్ యస్మాత్, యత్ మీన్స్ యస్మాత్ బికాజ్ యూ హ్యావ్ స్టేడ్ ఫర్ త్రీ నైట్స్, ఉషితవానసి యూ స్టేడ్ ఇన్ మై హౌస్ ఉషితవానసి, దెన్ గృహే మే మమ అనశ్నన్ హే బ్రహ్మన్ ఓ బ్రహ్మన్ యూ ఆర్ అన్ అతిథి. అతిథి ఈస్ సంబడీ హూ కమ్స్ టు యువర్ హౌస్ ఇన్ అ వెరీ వెరీ అన్ఎక్స్పెక్టెడ్ మ్యానర్. అతిథి అతిథి సన్ నమస్యః నమస్కారార్హః యు డిజర్వ్ ఆల్ సాల్యుటేషన్, యు డిజర్వ్ రెస్పెక్ట్, యు డిజర్వ్ టు బి వర్షిప్డ్, యు ఆర్ ఎ వెనరబుల్ పర్సన్. నమస్కారార్హశ్చ తస్మాత్ నమస్తే తుభ్యం భవతు. సో దిస్ రిగార్డింగ్ దిస్ త్రీ నైట్స్, వై షుడ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది సిగ్నిఫికెన్స్ ఆఫ్ త్రీ నైట్స్. ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ వన్ స్వామీజీ హూస్ నేమ్ ఐ మెన్షన్, హీఈస్ అఖండానంద సరస్వతి హూ స్టేడ్ ఇన్ వృందావన్. Right now he is not there. I think he passed away about 20 years ago, it looks like that. But he was supposed to be a very, very great teacher of Vedanta. So in his book he writes that Upavasa is for the three nights. Three nights means night represents darkness. The mantra is not saying three days. Mantra is talking about three nights. Night means darkness. Three types of ignorances. What are these three types of ignorance? So this is sattva, rajas and tamas, the status in which we are. And they say sattva and rajas and tamas, these are responsible for all our worldly activities. So this Nachiketa is a learned man. He is well versed in Vedas. He has surpassed that level. He knows. He has that nitya viveka, vasu viveka. He is only waiting for the final approval by Lord Yama. Otherwise, he is fully qualified to be called a Jnani. Just he is waiting for that final approval from Lord Yama. So it is like that. So sattva, rajas, tamo guna. Then he also knows that he is Atma. Which is beyond sthula sharira, sukshma sharira and karana sharira. So like this, he gives that interpretation. This Akhandananda, he says that sthula, sukshma, karana sharira, he realizes the tattvam, he realizes the essence of these things, and then realizes the essence means Atma is beyond this. Atma, that is I am beyond this thola sushma karana sharira. I am a guna atita. I am beyond these three gunas. So that awareness is there in Nachiketasa at a theoretical level. So that is the stage he says. And Upavasa is something is giving up all say sensory objects. Vishaya agrahanam. Upavasa is what? Not taking anything. Normally at a physical level, upavasa means say not eating any food, not taking anything inside, not having any say food or drink. So that is called upavasa. Upavasa at a philosophical level is vishaya agrahana. You are not taking anything inside. You are not having any, you are keeping your desires away. Keeping all the desires away. So that is a upavasa. So that is what he says. So that is in that adhyatma sthayi, without any sort of vishaya chintanam. That is without thinking about any worldly thing. అండ్ దెన్ ఎంగేజింగ్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఇన్ బ్రహ్మచింతనం. యాక్చువల్లీ ఇన్ ఉపవాస ఆల్సో వెన్ యు ఆర్ డూయింగ్ దిస్ ఏకాదశి ఉపవాస ఆర్ శివరాత్రి ఉపవాస, నాట్ సింప్లీ డూయింగ్ సమ్ నాట్ వాచింగ్ సమ్ టీవీ, నాట్ వాచింగ్ సమ్ ఫిల్మ్స్ ఆర్ ప్లేయింగ్ కార్డ్స్. పీపుల్ హూ వేకప్ ఇన్ ది శివరాత్రి నైట్, వాట్ దే డూ ఈస్ దే వేకప్ ప్లేయింగ్ సమ్ కార్డ్స్. సో దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ద థింగ్. యు ఆర్ సపోజ్ టు బీ థింకింగ్ అబౌట్ దట్ సుప్రీం లార్డ్, సుప్రీం రియాలిటీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ ది ఇంటెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ కీపింగ్ అవేక్. ఉపవాస ఈజ్ విషయ అవాయిడ్ విషయ చింతన అండ్ కీప్ యువర్ మైండ్ ఎంగేజ్డ్ ఆన్ బ్రహ్మచింతన. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది ఉపవాస. సో దట్ మీనింగ్ అఖండానంద గివ్స్. I thought it was a good meaning, and then so that's why I'm saying. So let us go to this bhashyam. Where is this? Hey Brahman.
Swasti.
Bhadram me astu.
Tasmat.
Bhavato anasanena. మద్గృహవాస నిమిత్త దోషాత్
విదౌట్ హ్యావింగ్ ఫుడ్ యూ స్టేడ్ ఇన్ మై హౌస్ అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ ఎ దోష, దట్ ఈస్ ఎ ఫాల్ట్. దోష మీన్స్ ఫాల్ట్. దట్ ఈస్ ఎ దోష ఆన్ మై పార్ట్. సో దట్ ఫాల్ట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి now say neutralized. Upashama is that has somehow it has to be neutralized. That fault has to be rectified. So the and bhadram me astu, that is let not any bad thing befall me, let only good befall me though I have committed this fault. So then
yadyapi
bhavad anugraheṇa
sarvam mama swasti syat
అనసనేన ఉపోషితాం ఏకైకాం రాత్రిం ప్రతి త్రీన్ వరాన్ వృణీష్వ అభిప్రేతార్థ విశేషాన్ ప్రార్థయస్వ మత్తః. ఓకే, యద్యపి భవద్ అనుగ్రహేణ సర్వం మమ స్వస్తి స్యాత్. దట్ ఈస్ దో ఐ నో దట్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ ఎ సార్ట్ ఆఫ్ హాట్ టెంపర్డ్ పర్సన్ హూ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు కర్స్ మీ. అతిథి క్యాన్ బీ సమ్ టైమ్స్ ఎ హాట్ టెంపర్డ్ పర్సన్ లైక్ దట్ దుర్వాస. సో ఐ నో దట్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ ఎ హాట్ టెంపర్డ్ పర్సన్, యు ఆర్ ఎ జెంటిల్ పర్సన్. అండ్ దో ఐ నో దట్ నథింగ్ బ్యాడ్ విల్ బిఫాల్ మీ, యద్యపి భవద్ అనుగ్రహేణ సర్వం మమ స్వస్తి స్యాత్, ఎవ్రీథింగ్ విల్ బి గుడ్ ఫర్ మీ ఓన్లీ. భవద్ అనుగ్రహేణ, బై యువర్ గ్రేస్ థింగ్స్ విల్ బి గుడ్ ఫర్ మీ. బట్ స్టిల్ తథాపి, బట్ ఈవన్ దెన్ త్వదధిక సంప్రసాదనార్థం. సో ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు ప్లీజ్ యూ మోర్, దో ఐ నో బట్ స్టిల్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు ప్లీజ్ యూ, త్వదధిక సంప్రసాదనార్థం. సంప్రసాదనం మీన్స్ టు ప్లీజ్ సంబడి, టు మేక్ సంబడి హ్యాపీ, టు ప్రొపిషియేట్ సంబడి. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ సంప్రసాదనం. సంప్రదానం ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్, సంప్రదానం ఈజ్ గివింగ్. సంప్రసాదనం ఈజ్ మేకింగ్ సంబడి హ్యాపీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ సంప్రసాదనం. సంప్రసాదనార్థం అనశనైన ఉపోషితాం ఏకైకాం రాత్రిం ప్రతి. సో యూ హ్యావ్ వెయిటెడ్ ఫర్ 3 నైట్స్ అండ్ ఏకైకాం రాత్రిం ప్రతి మీన్స్ ఫర్ ఈచ్ నైట్ త్రీన్ వరాన్ వృణీష్వ, యూ చూజ్ 3 బూన్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ యూ వాంట్. అభిప్రేతార్థ విశేషాన్ ప్రార్థయస్వ, యూ ఆస్క్ ఫర్ ఎనీథింగ్ విచ్ యూ డిజైర్, ఎనీథింగ్ విచ్ యూ వాంట్. సో దట్ ఇస్ ది సే యమాస్ రిప్లై, యమాస్ ఆఫర్ టు హిమ్. దెన్ నచికేత ఈస్ సెయింగ్ ది ఫస్ట్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఈజ్ లైక్ దిస్. లెట్ అస్ రీడ్ దిస్ మంత్ర. శాంత సంకల్ప సుమనాయ యథా స్యాత్ వీతమన్యుర్గౌతమో మాభిమృత్యో త్వత్ప్రసృష్టం మాభివదేత్ ప్రతీతః. ఏతత్త్రయాణాం ప్రథమం వరం వృణే. ఓకే, మై ఫాదర్ హీ మస్ట్ బీ ఇన్ సమ్ టెన్షన్, హీ మస్ట్ బీ అండర్గోయింగ్ సమ్ టెన్షన్ బికాస్ హీ హ్యాస్ సెంట్ మీ ఇన్ ఎ ఫిట్ ఆఫ్ యాంగర్, హీ హ్యాస్ సెంట్ మీ టు యమ. సో హీ మస్ట్ బీ అండర్గోయింగ్ సమ్, హీ మస్ట్ బీ హ్యావింగ్ సమ్ యాంగ్జైటీ. లెట్ హీస్ యాంగ్జైటీ బీ సెట్ టు రెస్ట్,
let him not have that anxiety. Shanta sankalpa. He must be having that sankalpa. He must be feeling that I have sent my son to Yama. And what is it that my son may be doing? What may be my son doing for Lord Yama? So he may be having some sort of worry like that. Let my father's worry be cooled. Let it be cooled down. Shanta sankalpaha. Sumanaha yathasyat. Sumana is sumanaha means what? Of a pleasant mind. Manas is mind. Sumana is a pleasant mind. Let him be happy. Sumanaha yathasyat. Then vita manyuhu. Manyu means anger. Vita manyuhu. Vigata manyuhu. Yasya vita manyuhu. So one whose anger has departed. So his anger has departed means, so earlier in a fit of anger he sent me. So again, when you are asking me to go back, let him not entertain the same feeling of anger. Let him not have that same anger towards me. Vita manyuhu gautamaha. Gautamaha means he is referring to that clan. So all these people, they belong to some gotra. So this gentleman belongs to that Gautama's gotra. So there are famous rishis in whose name there are some gotras. Kashyapaha Atri, Kashyapotri Bharadvaja, Vishwamitrasya Gautamaha, Jamadagni Vasishthavcha, Saptaite Rushayasthatha. So these Sapta Rishul, all these Sapta Rishis, these seven Rishis, and some other Rishis also. Not only these seven Rishis, these seven are supposed to be the primary Rishis. And in addition, there are several other Rishis. Kashyapaha Atri, Vishwamitra, Gautamaha, Jamadagni Vasishtha, Kashyapotri Bharadvaja, Vishwamitrasya Gautamaha, Jamadagni Vishishta. So like that, these are the rishis. So these rishis, some two or three rishis, their children, they're getting married. So that forms a gotram. So this, there are some gotrams which have the three rishis. There are some gotrams which have five rishis, five rishi names. That is called Pancharishaya. Three rishis, Trayarishaya. So here this gentleman, the main rishi is Gautama. There may be some two other rishis. So he is referring to that family name or that rishi name, gotra name. Okay. Then Gautama, ma abhi. Ma abhi means towards me. Ma abhi vita vitamanyuhu. Vitamanyuhu, that is without anger. Ma abhi, towards me. Then mrityo. Mrityo is sambodhana, addressing. Hey mrityo. Then tvat prasrushtam ma abhivadet pratitaha. Tvat prasrushtam, that is, you are releasing me, you are sending me back. Tvat prasrushtam, that is, having seen me, who is released by you. Tvat prasrushtam is one who is released by you. How? Ma abhivadet pratitah. Then this man, he should recognize me properly. He should not feel there is he has come in the form of a preta. Suppose a person who has gone to Yama, he comes back. Then you may feel that he is really some pretam. Bhuta preta, we know, dead man coming alive, people will be afraid. So let him not have any such feeling. So ma abhivadet pratitaha, having recognized me, let him not say anything unfair, let him not say anything bad. Then etat trayanam prathamam varam rune. Out of the three, this is the varam, this is the boon which I am choosing first. So this is the general meaning. But then if you see the words actually, there are certain words, very technical words which are used in this mantra. Shanta sankalpaha, sankalpa, then sumanaha, vita manyuhu. This sumanaha, sankalpaha, manyuhu, these are certain technical words which are used in certain with specific, special meaning. So if you see that, shanta sankalpaha, when you do a yajna, you are having so much of sankalpa. Sankalpa is mama. Upata Durtachaya Dwara, not only Upata Durtachaya, Mama Putra Potra, Hrudhyartham, Gotra, Hrudhyartham, this, that, etc. So much of Sankalpa you do. So Shanta Sankalpa is, let some wisdom dawn on my father. My father is doing all this Yajna, Yaga and all these things, expecting some results. The very word, the very opening words of this Upanishad said, Ushanha vai vajashravasaha, Ushanha vai kamayamanaha. With an intention, with a desire, this gentleman has started this yajna. So let that sankalpa become cool. That is shanta sankalpa. When will it become cool? Only when he starts doing some nishkama karma. Only when some sort of wisdom dawns on him. Only when some wisdom dawns on him, he will become a shanta sankalpa. Sumanaha. Sumanaha is another word for gods. Supervana Sumanasaha. Tridivesha, Divavukasaha, these are the words, these are the synonyms for gods. If you see Amarakosha, there is a, the, you know Amarakosha? Amarakosha is a dictionary in Sanskrit which is in verse, which is in verse form. So that was written by some Buddhist monk sometime in 2nd century or so. His name is Amarasimha. So that gentleman is in 2nd century or 3rd century AD. So he has written one dictionary in verse. So there he says, Amara Nirjara Deva Tridasha Vibhudha Suraha Suparvana Sumanasaha. Sumanaha, Sumanaha means God. Sumanasaha is plural. Suparvanaha Sumanasaha. So here the same word is used here, Sumanaha. That is one whose mind has become pure. So let his sankalpa come to an end. Let him not do say yaga with an intention for yajna phala with phalabhisandhi. Then let his mind become pure. Sumanaha yatha syat. Vita manyuhu. Manyu is another thing which we say want to get rid of every day. Every day you must be telling your in your sandhya vandan, what is that? Suryashchama manyushchamanyupatayashcha mannukrutimanyukutebhya papebhyo rakshantam. You must be saying that mantra. Suryashchama manyushchamanyupatayashcha. And then again in the evening you say agnishchama manyushcha. So manyu is something which you want to avoid every day in order to purify your mind. Manyu is something which, manyu is anger. Anger is something which pollutes your mind. So this, you have to get rid of this anger. There can be any other, very many reasons for this anger, but a person who is say a learned man, he is supposed to overcome his anger. He is supposed to have this nitya nitya vastu viveka. Then his viveka is supposed to produce some purity of mind, in which this anger, desire, greed, all these things, they have to get out. So that is another word, which is a technical word, which is used in this mantra. So if you see these words, this sankalpa, sumanaha, so you have to take, you can take a meaning at a different level also. That, let my father, he has been doing all this kamya karma. Let some wisdom dawn on him and then let him do some nishkama karma. Let him come to that nishkama karma level. So maybe that meaning also is underlying in this because of the choice of the words. So that is one thing. Let us read this bhashyam. Nachiketaha.
Nachiketaha
tu aha nachiketas tvaha yadi
ditsuhu varan
shanta sankalpaha upashantaha sankalpo yasya
mam prati
yamam prapya kimnu karishyati mam putraha iti
sa shanta sankalpaha
okay. Yadi ditsuhu varan. Ditsuhu means if you are desiring to give. Ditsuhu means datum icha ditsa. Ditsuhu means datum ichuhu. If you are desirous of giving this danam, this varams, varan, ditsuhu varan, then the first thing is shanta sankalpaha. Upashantaha sankalpaha yasya. Shankaracharya is also leaving it vague. Upashantaha sankalpaha. This let his sankalpa cool down. Sankalpa means two things. As I said, tension, worry about what his son may be doing. That is one sense. The second sense is his desires. All I want this, I want that. He must have desired sarvaveda samdadav. He wanted everything in the else in the world. So let that sankalpa cool down. So that is it. Upashanta sankalpaha yasya. Maam prati means regarding me, let him not have any tension. Then yamam prapya kimnu karishyati mama putraha iti shanta sankalpaha. Having gone to Yama, what may be my son doing? What is the fate of my son? I have sent him to Yama. We do not know what Yama is doing. So that is the tension which father may be having. Sa shanta sankalpaha. Next is sumanaha prasanna manascha yathasyat vitamanyuhu
vigata roshascha.
So sumanaha prasanna manaha means one with a pleasant happy mind. Then yathasyat, so let him become that. Then vitamanyuhu vigata roshascha, let that anger से गेट अवे फ्रॉम हिम लेट दैट एंगर गो फ्रॉम हिम विगत रोषा विगत रोषा मीन्स रोषा हैज डिपार्टेड फ्रॉम हिम सो लेट माय फादर बिकम लाइक दैट गौतम मम पिता मां प्रति हे मृत्यो ओ लॉर्ड यम लेट माय फादर से नॉट एंटरटेन एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ एंगर टुवर्ड्स मी एंड लेट हिम नॉट हैव एनी टेंशन रिगार्डिंग मी देन किंच त्वत् प्रसृष्टम् त्वया विनिर्मुक्तम् प्रेषितम् गृहं प्रति माम अभिवदेत् प्रतीतः लब्धस्मृतिः सयेवायं मम पुत्रः सयेवायं पुत्रः मम आगतः इत्येवं प्रत्यभिजानन् इत्यर्थः सो किञ्च मोरोवर् त्वत्प्रसृष्टं त्वया विनिर्मुक्तं When I get released by you and go home, he will see me who has been released by you. Tvat prasustam means one who has been released by you. Then, tvaya vinirmuktam preshitam gruham prati. One who has been sent home. Mam abhivadet pratitaha labdha smrutihi. So, he has to recognize me. He has to recognize me that, oh, he is the same boy whom I have sent to Lord Yama. He is the same boy. He is not a preta. He is not some dead person who is coming from the dead and then he is not of that type. Preta, you know. Preta, there is no equivalent word in English for preta. You can't call it devil. Devil is not a correct word. Here is preta is a dead person coming out from the dead. So, you are afraid of it. Something like a ghost. Let us say a ghost. It is not exactly ghost also, but let us say it is a ghost. Then he should not think that it is something like a ghost. That is, the ghost also is the meaning which is given by this Gopala iti. Preti bhuto yamad agataha anavalokaniyaha iti. So this is one interpretation given by Gopala iti Indra, but Shankaracharya is not saying that. Shankaracharya is leaving it rather vague. Mam abhivadet pratitaha labdhasmrutihi sayevayam putraha. The same, he is my own boy, he is my son. So let my father recognize me like that. Let my father recognize me as his son who has been sent to Lord Yama. Then, etat prayojanam trayanam varanam prathamam adhyam varam vrune prarthaye ayam यत् पितुः परितोषणम् सो द फर्स्ट वरम द फर्स्ट डिजायर इज अबाउट पितुः परितोषणम् जस्ट टू मेक हिज फादर हैप्पी मीन्स अगेन सो द सन विल गो बैक एंड देन फादर विल बी हैप्पी व्हेन हिज यज्ञ बिकम्स संपन्न व्हेन हिज यज्ञ बिकम्स फ्रूटफुल सो आफ्टर ऑल ही हैज गिवन आउट ऑल हिज ओल्ड काउस एंड डेक्रिपिट काउस सो इफ हिज यज्ञ हैज टू बी प्रॉपरली फुलफिल्ड Then he should grow, he should elevate himself to the level of that Nishkama Karma. So that is Pituh Paritoshanam. In order to make his father happy, that is the first varam. Yetat Prayojanam, this is the thing. Trayanam Varanam Prathamam Adhyam Varam Rune. This is the first varam, this is the first boon which I am requesting of you. That is, my father should be happy. Father should be happy not only by receiving me back, not only by recognizing me that I am the same son and I am not a ghost and all that, but also by having fulfillment of his yajna. So that is the meaning here. Then next mantra is, the reply by Lord Yama. Mrityu Ruvacha. Mrityu is saying, Yatha purastad bhavita pratitaha. Okay, pratita is the correct thing. Pratitaha, it becomes, when you translate, it becomes pratita. Pratitaha. Auddalakira runir mat prasrushtaha.
Auddalakira runir
mat arunir mat prasrushtaha. Mat prasrushtaha. Sukham ratri shayita. Vita manyuho. मृत्युमुखात् प्रमुक्तम् सो लॉर्ड यमा इज सेइंग ओके अकॉर्डिंगली ही विल बी लाइक दैट यथा पुरस्तात् भविता प्रतीतः प्रतीतः मीन्स having recognized you, labdhasmrutihi pratidaha, labdhasmrutihi, that's what he earlier we saw, labdhasmrutihi means having recalled you, then yatha purastat bhavita, your father will be like before means not in an angry mood, before becoming angry, he loved his son, so like that, he will be like that, as he was with you earlier in a very very pleasant fashion, he will receive you. Yatha purastat means earlier, bhavita means he will be, bhavita is in future tense actually, yatha purastat bhavita pratitaha, so he will be like that, say after seeing you, having recognized you, then auddalakihi arunihi mat prasrushtaha, auddalakihi arunihi means there are two family names which are given, auddalaki is son of uddalaka, Aruni is son of Aruna. Maybe he is having two family names, one from mother's side and one from father's side. It looks like that. That is what Shankaracharya also says. Dvyamushyayanaha, he says. Dvi plus Amushyayanaha. That is two family names. That is one is Uddalaki and one is Aruni. It doesn't matter. That is son of Uddalaka and son of Aruni. So he may be having to, or maybe he is taken on as a adopted by another father. So it may be something like that also. It is possible that somebody is adopted. So this family name, original name also, gotram also will be there, and the other thing, naturally the other one comes. But then in normal usage, you may sometimes use both the gotra names. So something like that. Auddalaki arunihi mat prasrushtaha, because of my will, because I am giving you this boon, I am changing his mind, I am influencing his mind, because of my volition, my will, my boon, because of my blessing, your father will receive you normally, your father will be as loving as earlier, and then he will recognize you properly. Then sukham ratri shayita, so he will also sleep well in the nights. So when somebody, an angry man, he will not sleep well in the nights. So maybe that this Vajasravasa was one such person who was always tensed up and he was not having proper sleeps. Then sukham ratri shayita, he will also be a person who will have good sleep in the nights. Then vitamanyuhu, that is vitamanyu we saw earlier, that is one whose anger is gone away. Then Tvam Dadrushivan, he will see you. Tvam Dadrushivan, he will see you. Mrityumukhat Pramuktam. So one who has come out from the Mrityumukha. Mrityumukha, literally speaking, Mrityumukha is from the jaws of death. Mukham actually in Sanskrit, it means two things. Mukham means face and also mouth. Mrityumukham. So we say somebody is in Mrityumukham. So he is almost being grabbed by Mrityu, he is almost being chewed up by Mrityu. So metaphorically we say he is being chewed up by Mrityu. So Mrityu Mukhat means from the jaws of death. From the jaws of death you have been sent back. So Yama is not a cruel person. Yama is only somebody who is Karma Phala Adhikari. He is actually Karma Phala Adhikari. Whatever karma you have done, he is only ensuring that karma phalam comes. So Yama is not a cruel person. Yama is something like a judge. Yama is something like a judge who will only give you that karma phala. So if the fellow dies, naturally that metaphorically is called, he goes into the mouth of Mrityu. Metaphorically it is called, he goes into the mouth of Mrityu. It is not as though Lord Yama is eating up people. It's not like that. So Mrityu Mukhat Pramuktam Tvam Dadrushivan. He will see you, who has been, you means you have been released from the jaws of death. So then he will also recognize you. He will see you like that. And then he will be happy. So that is what he is saying. Let us read this. Yatha buddhistvayi purastat purvam asit sneha samanvita pituhu tava bhavita preeti samanvitah
tava pita
tathaiva
Pratitavan san auddalakihi.
Auddalaki. So this Uddalaka son, Pratitavan san, that is having recognized you. Then यथा बुद्धिस्त्वयि पुरस्तात् जस्ट आई मीन लाइक ही वॉज हैविंग सम लव एंड अफेक्शन फॉर यू एज अर्लियर सो ही विल बिकम लाइक दैट जस्ट एज ही वॉज हैविंग लव एंड अफेक्शन अर्लियर ही विल ऑल्सो बिकम लाइक दैट यथा बुद्धि त्वयि त्वयि मीन्स इन यू पुरस्तात् मीन्स पूर्वम दैट इज इन अर्लियर आसीत् एज इट वॉज स्नेह समन्वित मीन्स वेरी 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 कॉर्डियल lot of love and affection that is sneha samanvita then that type of love and affection he will show then preeti samanvitah tava pita tathaiva pratitah then pratitavan san uddalaki this uddalaki who is your father he will be showing love and affection as earlier then uddalaka eva uddalakihi arunasya apatyam arunihi द्व्यामुष्यायणो वा मत्प्रसृष्टः मया अनुज्ञातः सन् इतरापि रात्रीः सुखं प्रसन्नमनाः शयिता स्वप्ता नाट् स्वप्तः स्वप्ता युवर् बुक्स् इस् सुप्तः ओ इट डजंट मैटर सुप्ता श्वेता सुप्ता इट इज ओके श्वेता स्वप्ता दे आर इन बोथ इन द सेम लकार ओके देन दिस इज यथा उद्दालक एव उद्दालकी उद्दालक इज सेम एज उद्दालकी देन अरुणस्य अपत्यम अरुणी दीस आर तद्धित प्रत्ययस वी नीड नॉट बदर द्व्यामुष्यायण अमुष्यायण मीन्स पर्सन बिलांगिंग टू ए पर्टिक्युलर गोत्र फोर मिनट्स Amushyayana is a particular belonging to a particular gotra. Dvyamushyayana, he is having two family names. Then, Dvamushyayana va, it may be like that, he says. Then, Mat Prasrushtaha Maya Anugnatasan. So, by my will or by my direction, by my volition, then Maya Anugnataha by my blessing, then Itara Piratrihi Sukham Prasannamanaha Shaita Swapta. So, the rest of the nights also, in the coming times also, he will be happy, he will sleep happily, he will not undergo any sort of tension. Sukham shayita syat, that is, he will have very happy nights. Then, vita manyuhu, vigata manyuscha bhavita syat,
tvam putram,
dadrushivan,
दृष्टवान् सन्
मृत्युमुखात् मृत्युगोचरात् प्रमुक्तं सन्तम् सो ही विल् बी वेरी हैप्पी मृत्युगोचरात् प्रमुक्तं सन्तम् सो फ्रम् दिस् फ्रम् द जास् आफ् डेथ् यू हेव् बीन् रिलीस्ड् अण्ड् ददृशिवान् सन् ददृशिवान् मीन्स् दृष्टवान् सन् हेविङ्ग् सीन् यू ही विल् बी वेरी वेरी हैप्पी And then Vitamanyuhu Vigatamanyuscha Bhavita, he will also get rid of his anger, he will also not have any sort of anger towards you, and then he will sleep happily, and then he will also treat you very kindly and with the same warmth, with the same say love and affection. So that is the meaning here. Then the next line is Nachiketa. The Nachiketa is going for the next varam. So next one, we'll let us read this mantra. Time is over or 1 or 2 minutes?
2 minutes.
Okay. Swarge loke.
Swarge loke.
Na bhayam kinchanasti.
Na bhayam kinchanasti.
Na tatratvam.
Na tatratvam.
Na jaraya bibheti.
Na jaraya bibheti.
Ubhe tirtva.
Ubhe tirtva.
Ashanaya pipase.
Ashanaya pipase.
Shokati go modate.
Shokati go modate.
Swarga loke.
Swarga loke.
So he is giving a description of Swargaloka. Of course, in the next mantra, he is going to ask for the means for that Swargaloka. The means for Swargaloka is Agni. Agni means particular type of sadhana, a particular type of a procedure, some type of yajna, which he is going to attain, which is going to give a person Swarga. Then before asking that, he is just describing what exactly is that swarga. So he is, what is the swarupam, swarga swarupam, what is the nature of that swarga, he is describing. Swarge loke na bhayam kinchanasti. We know that swarga is different from moksha. This is one thing which we have to remember. Moksha, Gita students, of course, for a long time they have been listening, but somebody who has just entered this Kathakopanishad class, he may not be knowing the difference between swarga and moksha. मोक्ष इज समथिंग विच इज अटेंड बाय ज्ञान ज्ञानात् मोक्ष ज्ञान मीन्स आत्मज्ञान सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन दट ईज सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन ओनली वेन ही नो वेन ही रिजेक्ट्स वाट आल इज नॉट सेल्फ एंड वेन ही आइडेंटिफाइज हिमसेल्फ विद द ब्रह्मन वेन ही रियलाइजेस नॉट आइडेंटिफाइज आई मीन फोर्सिबली when he realizes that he is nothing else but that brahma consciousness that is the state of moksha where there is absolutely no desire where he is in a total state of bliss satyam jnanam anantam brahma he will be in that state so that is moksha swarga is different swarga is a particular level of happiness swarga means he is in a particular a happy state that's all from that happy state there is a return But from moksha there is no return. Moksha means you are merging yourself in Brahman. Whereas swarga is something which is attainable. Swarga is something which is attainable by a karma. Moksha is not attainable by karma. Moksha is not attainable by doing some yajna. Moksha is attainable only by thinking, shravana, manana, nididhyasanam. Only by thinking and contemplation moksha is achieved. But not by a karma. Swarga is achieved by karma. So that is the basic difference. So swarga again there is always a return. So just as a person goes with a visa and then comes back, so swarga is somewhat like that. So then swarge loke na bhayam kincha nasti. So there is no bhayam. Bhayam means all types of worldly fears. Worldly fears means janma, mrityu, jara and all these things. In swarga there is no question of disease. There is no question of any type of bhayam. Bhaya. What is this? Marana, Ashanaya, Pipasa, Shokarahita. So there is no question of hunger. There is no question of hunger or thirst. So all these things will not be there. Natatra Tvam. You are also not there. The Mrityu is not there. Swarga is a place where Mrityu will be absent, at least temporarily. Then Na Jaraya Vibheti. There is no old age there. There is no Jara. Because the devas, they are called nirjara, and there is no old age for them. There are only three stages, that is childhood, adolescence and youth. So only three, there is no old age. Balyam, kaumaram and yavanam, only these three stages are there. That is why they are also called tridasha. Only three stages are there, there is no fourth stage called jara. They are also called nirjara. So na jaraya bibheti, there is no fear of old age there. Then ubhetirtva ashanaya pipase, this ashana pipasa, that is hunger and thirst are also not there. Shokatigaha modate swargaloke. So a person who goes to swargaloka, he is very happy, who has gone beyond all these shokas. Shoka means worries. All these worldly worries will not be there in that pleasant state called swarga. So I want to know about that swarga is the next mantra. So we will see that bhashyam in the next class. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेव अवशिष्यते ओम शांति शांति शांति।